Ever wonder how some people seem to magically extract data from websites while you're still copying and pasting to an Excel sheet like it's 1999? That's called web scraping. And it just got ridiculously easy with AI. Normally, gathering data online means either doing it painfully by hand or using technical coding stuff most people just don't want to deal with. Now, Thunderbit's AI pulls data from multiple pages and drops it neatly into your spreadsheet or database in just two clicks. No coding and no hassle. Plus, it just got a major update that allows you to scrape up to 2,000 pages at once. And you can even scrape from files and images. In this video, I'll show you how this powerful Chrome extension can save hours of your day and walk through real-world examples so you can use it on your own projects. Let's dive in. To install, click the first link in the description. And on this page, now we can hit either Add to Chrome or Install from Chrome Web Store. From here, we can click Add to Chrome, and it will ask if you want to add it to extension. Then we add extension. On this puzzle icon, make sure that the Thunderbit is pinned to our extension so we can always have access to it. Let's open Thunderbit. The first time you log in, you'll see a playground where you can try to use Thunderbit to extract these information. This is a directory of a company. Once we open the extension, you can see the Thunderbit panel open on the right-hand side. Let's try to scrape this page and see if we can actually complete the scraping in just two clicks. So the first challenge we face when scraping a website is knowing what to collect and making sure it's actually usable afterward. That's where this tool really helps. Here we want to extract the profile information of the people with Thunderbit. The first step is to choose a data source, and we can choose from current page, and we can also paste URLs or even uploading file and images here. Let's try to scrape the current page. So the second step is to determine what we want to scrape from this data source. Since it's not a popular site that already has a built-in template, we can ask AI to suggest fields to scrape by reading what's on the page. Or you can enter in fields manually if you want, but who wants to do that? Let's click AI suggest. It will then read the data, understand the structure, and give you suggestions of what data you may want to collect from this page. So here are what the AI suggests for us. And you can see that we have full name, profile image, job title, department, email address, phone number, and even office location. So all the information that is on the page that is relevant for scraping. And you can see that if we click edit to get into the field editor, we'll see there's a field AI prompt. And the AI briefly explained what the field should be about. For example, in this full name, it says the full name of the person, for example, John Smith. Another thing I really like is that it already predetermines the proper field type for each field. And you can also easily change the field type, such as text, selection, number, date, email, phone number, URL, or image. You can see that all these fields are labeled properly with the proper field type. Like for example, this one is phone number and this one is email address. So the field type is very important when you extract information to a database like Airtable or Notion template, especially if you want to further automate the process. You'll see that later in the example. And let me show you how to leverage their AI feature. So let's say we want a column for gender. Let's edit the field AI prompt. Here we can use our natural language to tell the AI what we want. Here I put in infer their gender from their name. It can be female, male, or unsure. Okay, and then click save. This is the information that is not explicitly on the page, but let's see if the AI can get it right. Actually, we can change the field type also to single select for this one because we only give three options and you just have to select a single one from there. For the output, we can either output it as a table and download it as a CSV or JSON file, or we can directly save the file into your Google Sheet, Airtable, or Notion, and then you can further do tons of other things afterwards. This is super helpful if you want to include the scraping as part of your automation process, since you can do integration like Zapier or Make.com from these platforms. Let's try outputting as a table first. Okay, it's taking longer than it should because I'm explaining the process, but literally this should take only two clicks or three. Now let's click scrape and see how the magic happened. You can see that Thunderbit is scraping and task in progress. It's running pretty fast. We have our table just like that. Click to see the full view. And we got a neatly scraped sheet like this just by clicking around. It got the name, the image, the job title, the department, email, phone, and office location, and even the gender that I specify. For the images, you can click download to have a zip folder with all the images in the same folder. Let's see. Like this. Also, more incredibly, it correctly labeled the gender of each person by analyzing their other information even though it's not on the page. There's just so much you can do with this. But you might be thinking, okay, that's great for a basic page. What if I want to pull structured data from a big site like Instagram? We're on the Instagram page of a really popular hotpot restaurant in my area. Let's say I'm a competitor and I want to study their social media post and steal their secret sauce. Pun intended. Let's open Thunderbit. When you're on the popular site like Instagram, Thunderbit sometimes shows pre-built template option like this. For this page, we can choose Instagram profile posts and Instagram profile details. I want to study how they create their content, so I'll select Instagram profile post. Let's use their pre-built. When we click open the template, you'll see that it already has all the fields you'll normally want to collect for this page. For example, post URL, cover image, description, posted user profile, content type, tags, date posted, numbers of likes, photos, video view count, number of comments, latest comments, and followers. Some information like the latest comment or description usually require clicking into each post like this, which makes traditional scraping a pain in the but not with Thunderbit. Let's just use this template and see what we get. This time, let's send the output directly to Notion. And then we'll have to log into a Notion account. And then Thunderbit will request access to one of the page. So we can select a page and allow access. Here we will select a page where we want to send the data to. Here we can determine our database name and then click save. So we will save all the output into this hotpot intel page that we just created. Now let's scrape and see what happened. We already got the table and it is currently saving to the Notion page. Okay, it's done. Let's click open the Notion page. Let's see what we get. So we have the post URL, content type properly get in. I don't really know what the cover page should be. Date posted and all the description of each post, the followers, latest comment, which you have to click in to see normally. Numbers of comments, likes, posts. You can see the picture. It is attached as an image. And also the video.
Excuse me? Hey, what's up? Do you like free food?
All the relevant information for competitive analysis is there. You can easily analyze the data to your advantage. For example, you could click the user profile links to contact influencer who posted about this brand, and you can open the video links to study their content type and see how to create similar video. This is definitely a tool every marketer would love to have in their toolkit. Templates are a game changer to save time. But what if I want to scrape a site that has no pre-built template? Or what if I want to scrape multiple product pages? Let me show you some more Thunderbit magic with other examples. Here we are at Allbirds online store and its new arrival page. We can see that it can be scrolled down all the way until here we see the show more button. Then we'll have to click show more to see more products. For this, we'll use Thunderbird's pagination feature to automatically click through the next pages. First, we can see that there's a pagination button, and when we open it, we see three options. If you want to scrape content only on this page, we can click no pagination. And if we want to scrape content by clicking through the next button, then we can select click pagination. And there's some websites that have infinite scroll where you have to scroll down more to see more content. And in that case, we can select infinite scroll. We'll select click pagination since we have the show more button. Next, there will be a pop-up telling you to select the next button on this page. Once we select show more, there will be another pop-up saying that you can select the page and all the way to maximum 200 pages. I think in this case, we'll just select three pages and click next. And next, it says that you can click scrape to start, but make sure that there's a correct scrape template is selected. So for this page, let's ask AI to set some fields for us to select. After analyzing the page, this is what AI gave us. We have product name, product URL, price, product page, product image, available sizes, and color. So let's just try and see what we get. Okay, now we have 88 entry. I think it did flip through the second page, but it just doesn't have a third page because they don't have more than two page of content in their new arrival. This is great. Okay, we got all the information we need. But sometimes we want to also include the information in the product page in this table. In that case, we'll have to click into each product to its subpage, which is the product page, to get more information. So let's try that as well. Let's try to get to the next page. So on this product listing, we want to get into the product page to collect more information. We'll use the scrape subpage. Let's try scrape subpage. And then it will go into a product page and read through the information to know what we can scrape from this page. So here are the existing fields of our original table. And now we can add or append more fields into the table by going into a product page and read other information inside the page. These are the suggested new fields by the AI after it scraped through the page. So you can see that there's product highlight here, and also there are material, there are care guide, and there's shipping and return. So you have to click through one by one to get the information. And also there are customer reviews on this page. We can select either scrape via browser or scrape in the background. I think we'll select scrape via browser to see how it works. Let's scrape, and you see that it is scraping one page at a time of product page that we have on our original table. And finally, we have all 88 pages scraped. Let's see if we have all the product. So now we have not only the ones that we had before, there are more information after the AI go into each page and read about the highlights and the materials, the care guide, the shipping and return, and also the customer review. This is pretty cool. Imagine if you hire an assistant to do this, they have to go into each page and grab the information and spend time filling out all the fields that are required. And this is just a few clicks for me. This kind of deep scraping with pagination and subpage extraction is what makes Thunderbit insanely powerful for researchers, e-commerce sellers, and data geeks like me. With just a little setup, we've saved hours or days of tedious copy-pasting. Other than the AI web scraper, there are also other really cool features that Thunderbit has that would really help with the process. One thing is that you can schedule scraper to do your scraping in a set schedule. For example, you can set up a schedule like every morning at 9 a.m. or every workday at 5 p.m. And you can assign the time zone as well. And you can enter the URL to scrape. Set up a template just like before and add an alert either through email or Slack after each execution is finished. This kind of automation scheduling can be integrated with your automatic workflow that will help you automate a lot of process after you output the data into a database that can be integrated with other automation software. Also, another super cool feature is the AI autofill. Let me show you how it works. So from here, we can input our knowledge. For example, let me upload this resume that is a fake resume of mine. And we're on a job post page. And now with autofill, we can actually ask the AI to fill in the fields for us by reading our resume. For example, let's click fill and see what happened. Okay, you can see that the information from the resume is parsed. These are not my real information, so don't stalk me. A lot of the information is filled into the form. You can save so much time if you have to apply for multiple jobs and each and every one of the job asking you a lot of questions that you don't want to manually answer. Another really cool thing is their email extractor, phone number extractor, and image extractor. And according to their email, these tools are free forever. So on this page, we have a lot of the staff with their email inside when you hover. Let's see if we can grab the emails from this page. Now, with just one click, you get all the email from this page. On this page, let's try the phone extractor. Now we have all the phone that is on this page in one place where you can just copy all and paste in somewhere else. This is the Amazon page of cat hammock. And we have all these products. And let's try image extractor. And you can see with just one click, we can have all the images extracted and we can just download all to get all the images on this page. This is very handy, useful tools that will save you so much time if you have to do something like this. Also, you can change the display language on Thunderbit to other languages, and they have 36 languages in total for you to choose from. And here is their product pricing page. So the plans start at $9 per month if you pay yearly, and you have a 31% discount if you go with a pro plan. Here is the monthly plan. They also have a free plan where you get 6 pages per month. You can get data export, AI autofill, and data extraction tools. For the starter plan, the monthly price starts at $15. It includes everything in free, plus subpage scraping, pre-built scraper, both scraping, pagination, data enrichment, and up to 5 scheduled scrapers. For the pro plan, you got everything including the starter, plus the unlimited data retention, unlimited scrapers, up to 25 scheduled scrapers, and minimum monitor frequency for 5 minutes. They also have the business plan, and you can contact them for more details. If you ever feel stuck manually copy-pasting data, this extension is an absolute game changer. If you want to try it out for free, just grab the link below and start using it to 10x your research workflow. Hit like if you found this helpful. Subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Mia, and I will see you in the next one.